In part two of asset accounting, we saw how to assign the GL account to account determination and how we can create the GL account and all. So now we'll do the remaining configuration. These are all basic configuration. It is not mandatory. These are many of them are optional configuration, but we'll look this configuration. Now we'll go back, minimize it, go to asset accounting again. Under asset accounting, what we have to do is, these are all optional one, it is not mandatory. So if you want, you can skip this part. Click on transactions. Under transactions, go to gain and loss. Under transactions, go to retirement. Under retirement, go to gain and loss posting. Under this, click on asset retirement. Click on execute. And make sure that our company code has a net book value here. By default, it will come. Again, then we'll go to the next step. Minimize it. Click on transaction. Under transaction, we have specify how default asset value date is determined. Click on execute. Double click on SN value date variant to the company code and give your company code here, or you can directly see here it is by default showing as a SAP default. If you want, you can keep it blank. That is also fine. It is not required, as I said. These are all optional one. Now we'll go to close this one. Minimize this. Go to asset accounting. Under asset accounting, go to asset data transfer. Under asset data transfer, go to primary data transfer. Primary data transfer, here we have to make sure that define transfer date and additional parameters. Go here we have to select our company code and give the configuration that we will look at later, and then specify the offset account for ledger. So here ITC, we have this GL account. This will also we'll see. Then this configuration, under this configuration, define test for transfer option items. So we don't need to do anything here. Okay, so here first we'll define our dates. So select this one, double click on it, and click on display change option here, and the create option will activate. So once the create option is activated, what we have to do is give a transfer date. So I will give the transfer date as 1/10, and legacy data transfer in preparation. And any other information, document type, if you want to give the document type, you can give here, or else not required. Document type also, it's up to you whether you want to give it or not. Now click on 0L, double click on it. Reporting fiscal year is failed, an exception. Ignore this one. Just click on enter and try to press enter. So here it should give. Just a second. Here, okay. and click on save here. Okay, after click on save, then double click on 0L, press enter. Just give it to highest as 01. Okay, so here you will see the close fiscal year. Then after that, give this as a 21. So you will see the close fiscal as 2021. Okay, now for IN also we'll do the same thing. Here you will find, double click on P001. So here you will see transfer date as 1/10/21. Then click on save. So this is how we are. Document type is missing for company code P001. That is okay, fine. Click on save. Then go to specify offsetting account for legacy data transfer. Execute this one. And you will see our chart of account is ITC. So we have created this GL as legacy data transfer GL. Go to FS00. Give this GL account, press enter and check what configuration we have done. Balance sheet, asset accounting. You can give the proper naming also, that is one. We have created this as a recon GL, and field status group we have created as G001, or if you want you can give a recon account GL also, that is okay. So this is how we have created the GL account. After this, we have one more step in asset accounting. That is, go to configuration, minimize this, then go to asset accounting. Under asset accounting, special valuation somewhere. Special valuation. Under special valuation, preparation for consolidation. If you are doing a consolidation, then this step is required. Specify group depreciation areas. So in this case, we don't want to do it and we'll keep it blank. That is fine. After doing all this configuration and all these settings, what we can do is we can just cross check the consistency. So to check the consistency, we'll go to preparation for go live. So this is the option, preparation for go live, and check consistency. Report company code. Go back. Everything is fine. If any error is there, it will show the errors. Give the asset class and check everything is fine or not. Then give the consistency report for FIAA customization. So this is important. All these above one are optional one. It is not such as required. This is the main report, consistency report for FIN. Yeah, errors occurred. Company code, errors, control data, warning have been generated, errors occurred. So let's see what are the errors. So this is not related to our company code. Fine. So we have to check whether we have anything for our company code or not. BALL, that is fine. So this is how we can check if any errors are there or not for our chart of account or our company code. Okay. Now go back. This is how we can check, do the consistency check. Now there is one more transaction. I don't remember the name. What we have to do is, just a second, we'll go to asset accounting. Under asset accounting, go to integration with general ledger accounting. I think we already did this one. Under this, specify posting key for asset accounting. Specify posting keys for asset accounting. Yeah, execute this one. This we already done. Asset postings, additional asset accounting, ANC. We already did this one. LTD. We already saw this one. ANL. This is the normal postings. ANS. This is also normal postings. So nothing is needed here. So after this, all the configuration is done. What we have to do is go back. And do one closer for the last financial year. So this is mandatory. So even if you have not posted anything, we have to run the GL account closer. So FAGL GVTR, just press enter and give your company code P001 GL carry forward. We are carry forwarding it from 2020. Give a test run and store original PL. Okay, then execute. Check if any errors are coming. This is fine. Just a warning message we are getting. Just remove the test run and execute. Yeah, that is fine. Click on enter. So we have done the normal run. After that, go to /n AS01, create a asset. So asset is P001. So before that, we'll create one cost center also and profit center also. Let's say cost center KS01. Sorry. Admin violation area. Let's say start with. .01.01.2021. Give the name P001 admin. P001 admin. And give the person responsible. And let's give P001 only. Call center hierarchy. Give star. Give the hierarchy. Whatever is the standard hierarchy, we'll take that one. For this one, we'll take the standard one. Company code. We have been creating this for P001. Business area not required. Okay. Then we'll go for the standard hierarchy. Press enter. It's my mistake. I have wrongly given the cost under KS01. Controlling area. I need to change the controlling area here. Extra set controlling area. So my controlling area will be ITC, I think. Let me check what is the controlling area we have created. ITC, yeah. So we'll create under ITC. I have wrongly taken that under ITC. Okay, press enter. It's already exists, no issue. Just give it 01. Press enter and give the remaining details. P001 admin, P001 person responsible is P001. Cost center star standard hierarchy as company code P001 and profit center any profit center does not exist, not an issue. Cost center hierarchy will give administration and save. So this is how we have created one call center which will be used for creation of a assets. Okay, so I'm stopping this part here, then we'll continue with the asset creation and all. Or else what we will do is we will extend one. Yeah, we'll continue later on. That is fine. We'll create a part 4 for asset accounting, and remaining that is like creation of master data and the GL postings and everything we'll cover there in part 4. So up till 3, part 1, part 2, part 3 are related to configuration. Part 4 will be a end user activity. Thank you.